All right, so third email is from Martin Wimpress. If you guys listen to Jupiter Broadcasting stuff, he's Wimpy in the chat room.
Or if you're into the UbuntuPodcast.org, Ubuntu Podcast, he's one of the few regular guys over there.
Yep, four of them, right? He writes, "Hi guys, I am the project lead for Ubuntu Mate. I've been listening to your podcast for a few months now and heard you'll be conducting a review of some distros over the coming weeks and months. Please consider Ubuntu Mate in your reviews, as I think it currently meets some of your third worldable requirements and would be interested in hearing your thoughts. Anyway, thanks for the podcast, and maybe you give one that I co-present a listen." So that's the Ubuntu UK podcast. The
Ubuntu podcast.
I keep on calling you way, the UK.
It's been a long time since you probably went to the website.
Sorry.
Subscriptions, baby. Yeah.
Post... Also, they changed their RSS feed some time ago. Postscript, okay. I'm also an Arch Linux trusted user, so I fully expect Ubuntu Mate to get stomped by your review of Arch. Best regards, Martin. Long-time listeners of Channel 14 know this is not the Martin that we keep on talking about, who's a wrestling fan.
Yeah, that's a different type of Martin, who will hopefully make an appearance someday.
Yeah. Hopefully. Right, so that's why we're here, man.
And that's why we're here. And let's give a brief background of our knowledge of mate before we go to what we know about mate now. Did I make sense? I made sense.
yeah, because Paolo, man, whenever we're like discussing it in the chat, he's always like, "Oh, what distro are you gonna be reviewing?" Okay. So the Ubuntu Mate edition. Mate is a, and I'm reading from the about Mate because, you know.
Why not?
Yeah, they have it in the distro. It's Mate 1.8.2 that they have on 1504. And if you had no idea what Linux was all about, that sounded really weird. Anyway. Right, so Mate is a fork of GNOME 2. Hundreds of people have contributed code to GNOME since it was started in 1997. Oh, no, GNOME turns 18. So it's sort of, GNOME turned 18 last Saturday, I think. So I guess this is like a good sort of, anyway. Yeah, basically it's a fork of GNOME 2. So, it's a lot like your, Ubuntu's, your Fedora's back in, 2010,
as I remember, I think. Yeah, I still quite remember 2009. Yeah, like, it was a bad year. Oh, are we talking about computers? Okay. If we're talking about computers.
That was the year that your laptop died, right?
Yeah.
2009.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that. It was a Windows 7 laptop or Windows XP laptop?
And you're like, it was a Vista laptop.
Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, Vista.
Yeah.
Anyway. So, the Mate desktop environment is sort of a fork of GNOME 2 because GNOME 3 came in around 2011, maybe 2012, mm-hmm. thereabouts. And it changed the entire desktop metaphor, right? Like, it didn't have the start menu or whatever you wanted to call it.
Yeah.
But, you know. So, and GNOME 3 wasn't very good in its initial, in its initial rollout. But, you know, it got a lot better. It's now my favorite desktop environment.
Exactly. That's what I'm about to say.
But, you know. The Mate desktop environment is, like, initially I thought it would be sort of for the curmudgeon in all of us, but then it's a little bit more than, I think that distinction goes to XFCE. Like, XFCE yes. is for the curmudgeon. Like, I'm, you know, planting my foot and this is it, you know. especially if you, like, install straight XFCE without any of the, without any of the bells and whistles that any of the other distributions put in, it's straight out of 95, you know? Which is not the case with Mate.
Yeah, I agree. So, right. Mate is the one distro that you always recommend, not just to me, but to anyone. You've been pestering me to put Mate ever since, yeah. And now I have it.
Yeah.
And here we are.
Yeah, well, actually, what was that? I might as well get that out of the way.
Yeah.
I don't use this distribution. Like, I don't. Because Arch. And I'm sure Wimpy will understand. Because he's the guy that packages the Mate packages for Arch. So, you know, I really don't use Ubuntu Mate. But I recommend it to...
Anyway.
Everybody. Yeah. Like... Upenga.
Yeah.
I can't remember what episode that was. Yeah, Lorelai.
Early episodes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, might as well give them a plug. They're a little non-profit that works out of Boston. And what they do is they get old laptops, old computers, refurbish them, throw Linux on it, and send it to kids in Samoa.
All sorts of cool.
Remember that?
Yeah, all yeah. sorts of cool.
And I was about to say something about professional wrestlers and career opportunities, but that might be insensitive.
Again, we do not condone such words in actions, but I should have followed up with, it doesn't matter. Anyway, enough with the wrestling jokes.
Yeah. And they were having trouble getting a light enough distribution to fit on some PowerBooks. Some of those old Mac PowerBooks, which donated to them. So Lorelai asked me, like, what would be a good distribution to put on this? My recommendation was Mate, especially since I found out that they have their PowerPC port. Like, the Ubuntu Mate project has a PowerPC port now, so I was like, you should try this out. And if that works out, then some kids in Samoa
are probably using Mate right now.
Yeah. What else? Our buddy Bok. His laptop's dying.
Well, he says it's dying, but...
It's Windows being Windows.
It's Windows being Windows. Jeez. It's just huffing and puffing and conking out and... Yep. I know that. Very classic.
Right. So let's get into our...
Thoughts.
Criteria. Well, actually, before we get into the criteria, what are we running it on? In case people didn't listen to our episode last week, right?
Mine is the Neo BC2BL netbook, which is available in the... Well, it's not manufactured in the Philippines. I mean, it's not for sale anymore. I've had this netbook for like 3 years now, and it is a very low spec netbook. Like, it runs on an Atom processor, 1.6 gigahertz, 2 gigabyte memory, about 10 inch monitor, and that's your very basic netbook.
I'm running this on my brother's old laptop, an Acer Aspire 5500Z. Came out 2004, 5, 6, maybe. It's got a whopping 1.73 gigahertz Pentium M processor, single core, 32-bit baby. About what was it? 2 gigs of RAM, I think, or gig of RAM? I'm not sure. And not top of the line graphics. The thing can't run SimCity 4. So,
well,
there we go. So that's what we're running Ubuntu Mate on,
which are very third world machines.
Well, I'm not sure, though, because I'd like to think that
yours is an old model.
Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure that most people here have something that's at least a dual-core system.
Because now that's now the standard issue.
Yeah, so there. So basically, when it comes to running on shit hardware, if it runs on this and you can get work done on the machines that... we're putting this on, then
it will be a beast in your machines.
Yeah, more or less. So there we go. Want to go first?
No. Okay, go first. My first thought is, of course, in my criteria, is it has to have an intuitive graphic user interface and a good desktop environment. It's Mate. So
we talked about the desktop environment at length.
Yeah. The GUI is already intuitive as it is. Like, what do you need? Why? What? What do you want from me? Okay, let's be constructive for a bit. I just clicked on Qt configuration. I just had to minimize it. See?
I think they tried to... What? I think they encourage you to pronounce it as cute.
Oh, okay. So, cute configuration. Cute like,
but you can't take that seriously, though.
Yeah, I can't. But the thing about, I like about Mate is that it's something familiar, but not necessarily something that is, it's not gonna stomp you, but you already know what to do with it when you see it. I'm pretty sure the first thing people are gonna do is click on the lower left, and then they're gonna see, oh, it's click here to restore hidden Windows. Oh, applications up there. Huh, let me click that. Oh, okay, everything's in here. Oh, all my files are at the places, and all those things. For me, that's very intuitive. Like, it's easy to navigate and go about the entire desktop. So, I mean, it's Mate.
It's like a urinal. You just sort of know what to do.
Yeah. Pretty much.
All right. My first criterion was fast. And, well, it runs on shit hardware. which means if you run it on anything else, it goes really fast. Or yep. It goes pretty fast. Although it isn't as fast as some of the lighter weight desktop environments. So there, but it's fast enough. It's sort of at the cusp of if you're gonna be deploying this at a public school, this would be anything heavier than this, I'm not sure. I'd be comfortable saying like, hey, maybe you should send these to kids in Samoa, yeah. but then the trade-off is it's more fully featured.
Yeah, because I'd like to think it's the floor of when it comes to the speedy or the lightweight distros or the lightweight desktop environments. Mate, I think, is at the floor. Like, it could only go faster from there. Like, if you put it up against LXDE or XFCE, those are faster, but the feature set of Mate is different.
Yeah. And you can speed it up, you know, you can choose not to use Compiz, but then
who why?
Not, yeah, like, why would you not use Compiz if it's available as an option?
Which brings me to my number two. It is smooth and can be sexified.
Sorry.
Because to me, like, my second criteria for good third world double distro is it has to be smooth, which means it's a right mix of speed and sexy. And the fact that it has Compiz, it can be sexified. You can, you know, tweak it up a bit. Like, I was looking at the Qt manager earlier, and there's so many things you can tweak that you could actually get lost in it to a fault. But I'm not sure if it's a good thing or a bad thing, but for those who really want to get into their systems, that's amazing.
Yeah, what was it? There was I can't remember the name of the package now off of the top of my head. Config settings manager. Like, that's where you can get that's where you can like tweak the cube. I miss the cube too. you can tweak the cube, you can get wobbly windows, yay, wobbly windows, you can get
ooh, when
that
you go
fiery
like
effect and
oh man, still love that day when I did a presentation on my laptop then in the Compiz. Everyone's like, what the hell were you doing? The future of computing.
It's really funny that that the future of computing is when was Mate was forked around 2011, 2012.
Yeah.
So like that was the future 4 years ago.
Well, I showed that when I was 2009.
Yeah, yeah. It's still really cool when people see like the
every time you do something like
Compiz cube or like that thing that he used to do where you have nine virtual desktops. And then
workspaces,
you can have them like fold out.
Oh yeah,
fold out like zoom out like boom.
Look at that! Behold, a very nice computing system.
Pretty fucking useless on a 14-inch screen, but it looked really good.
Gotta get them ladies. It's all for the ladies. Anyway, what next?
My next criterion was the repository, you know, standard like Ubuntu packages, which are sourced from Debian. It's pretty standard being all Ubuntu and stuff. But something that I want to add to this second criterion is sort of the software selection in the default state.
All right.
Because a lot of distributions differentiate from each other, sort of based on
the packages
the packages that it comes pre-installed with. That's something that I realized while doing Peppermint.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, the thing that I really love about Mate or Ubuntu Mate is that it comes with a backup utility.
Yes.
Like, nobody does that. Like, who does that?
Well, apparently they did, so.
Wow. I think it points to who this distro is designed for, right?
Hmm.
Because like us, like Linuxy people, like what we do by way of backup is, you know, we're gonna have a separate home partition.
Yes.
That way, you know, if we like nuke and pave, or if something happens to the root partition, well, the home partition is on a separate, well, your home folder is on a separate partition, so you can just install another distro and just point it to your home partition, right? That's our backup, but like not to the average user. So
it says something. Wow. Yeah, it says something for the type of user they're targeting.
Yeah, and it speaks to the attention to detail, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, we appreciate it, even though we know how to do, like,
even though I never use it.
Yeah. Well, I might, you know, being how I destroy distros, not destroy, but like how I torture machines.
But then, you know, an rsync on cron job, and it's synced to my folder server thing. Anyway. Yeah. There. So the software selection in its default, that's something that the backup utility is something that really stood out, because nobody does that. Other than that, it's all pretty like standard stuff, you know, like the.
Yep. We can really recommend this to Bulk.
All right.
Next up.
What do you have next?
Okay. For my next criteria for third worldable is it has to have a good community. Right? Right? And yep. Here's the thing. Martin Winpress asked, emailed us for his feedback. Because they value those things. Dude emailed us, man. I'm like, two things. One, holy shit, important people are listening. Number two, holy shit, an important person is asking for her feedback. And how is that gonna that's the type of thing that's gonna trickle down when they do their distro. Like, when they see what we talk about here, like, okay, now they know that we appreciate the fact that there's a backup. That's one of the things we like. And you're gonna harp on compis till the end of this review. We are gonna give praises that the fact that compis exists and you have something in the computer.
Thing.
Yeah, it's still a thing. Bring it back, yo. Bring it back. Comp is for life. and then there's a thing in your computer that is cute. So, like, those, yeah, they will appreciate those things. And not only that, we're not yet in our con section, but they're going to understand those things. And I think they're going to value it. And, you know, it's going to trickle down to everyone who will use it. They could easily get that.
All right, so next for me is installation process. An exhaustive installation process. Yeah, you know, it's the Ubuntu installer.
Yeah, yeah.
But then what I'm excited for, is if, because they're going to be removing the Ubuntu Software Center. And
yes.
If I understand it right, they're going to be like replacing it with something that looks more like Crunchbang's first run script, or like, you know, you can sort of select your packages or whatever.
I am very, very curious with how would that go, or how that would be implemented.
Yeah, but either way, I'm excited, because it's like, when you When you install a distribution, right, like the first thing I do is I pop open a terminal and sudo apt-get install whatever, or you sort of fill in what the distribution doesn't provide and remove the stuff that you don't want, that you don't really want.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So like to have that step automated as well, that's mm-hmm. something that's interesting, or that's something I look forward to.
For my case, it's a fairly, like, how brainless could, like, an Ubuntu install be? Like,
what?
What I mean is that we've been installing, or at least I've been installing Ubuntu or Ubuntu derivatives for the past how long have we been doing this? Not just 2 years, but been using Linux. Like, that's why I guess I was so happy with CrunchBang, because, oh my god, a different type of install. Oh, wow, 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 wow. And I absolutely love it. At this time, I got used already to installing an Ubuntu system that it's just, you know, second nature.
Yeah.
So, I'm brainless, of course, it is.
Then is it brainless because you've done it so many times? Or
yeah,
is it brainless?
No, that's what I'm saying. I'm guessing I'm going to be now have bias when it comes to that, because I've installed Ubuntu how many times already? Like, I know what to do anymore. Like, yeah, that. Mm-hmm. Okay. And wait. That's pretty much how I install Ubuntu nowadays. But the waiting time is agonizing because, oh my god, internet speeds of the third world.
Yeah.
I mean, how else can you make the Ubuntu install exciting? Like John Cena suddenly appears.
What's it?
Something.
No, you do what Antergos is doing, but then there's a little bit of a bug, but you know, whatever. They have a really good installer. And I think it's a fork of the Ubuntu, so I'm not sure. Anyway.
That's gonna be next, well, we're gonna say I thought we were saving that for later.
Yeah, we'll save it for whenever. Because
you have to fix that
bug. They're going through like a weird transition period, as it turns out. Or at least that's what the forum post said. Anyway. next up, the look and feel. Or it has to look good and it's a default. Yeah, it's green. Green is nice.
Space and green.
Yeah.
It's a trend now that, like, all, not green in space, but like, tabs have to be gray or dark in color. Like the bars.
Yeah.
Yeah, just pointing it out. It's not a critique or a commentary. It's just, like something like that. An observation, if you will.
Yeah. But then, like, as I was using the distribution, I realized that it doesn't have to look slick, right?
Oh, no, it doesn't. Those, I think, are for those who need to be fancified. What the hell is wrong with my English? Those who want it to look fancy.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, like it looks like a construction worker. That's how I described it.
Yeah, like, it is. Well, you know how I call it. It's the working man's distro.
Yeah. Well, no, it's it looks like it was designed by an engineer that has a good eye.
Yeah. Not a designer that, you know, an engineer, because everything seems functional.
Yeah, yeah. It looks like it was designed by somebody. It looks like it was designed by an engineer with a sense of aesthetics.
Yeah.
Right? That's the best way I can describe what it looks like in its default. but I will say, though, that it does look a lot better than the default Mate install.
No, of course.
But then that really isn't saying.
Because then again, I mean, it's plain, but it's not bland.
Yeah.
You don't really, personally, I don't think Mate is the type of distro that needs to show off and, oh, look at me, pizzazz, like, jazz hands. It doesn't need to do that.
Does he need to be jazz hands?
Yeah. But it can if you want it to, because, you know, comp is.
No, dude, I think that the jazz hands distro is
Voyager.
God, I'm the one that's forgetting it now. The one that your sister really likes.
Elementary,
yeah, that's the jazz hands distro. Jazz hands.
Jazz hands. It's really cool, but jazz hands.
And since you mentioned, and since you mentioned Elementary, that's the European indie film. It's a European indie film, Voyager OS.
Really?
Yeah, dude. It feels like a European indie film because it's French.
Oh, okay. I thought like there's an European indie film night of Voyager OS.
Voyager OS. Like, sorry.
Did Inarito did something like that? but yeah, Voyager OS is like your connoisseur. He likes the finer things in life. I say. He goes like that.
We should do that.
What?
We should do a third world treatment of Voyager.
We planned
that like a year ago, right? Like two years ago. About a year ago. Like, dude, we should do Voyager. Like, yeah.
And now we're doing a string of third world treatments. Might as well go at it.
All right.
looks like we have our next one.
Voyager.
We're gonna go
or Linux Mint, because Bok is thinking about doing Linux Mint.
Well, anyway. It's our show. We could do it back to back, you know, back to back. let's go back. Let's talk about that later.
another thing on the look and feel that I really like is in the Mate tweak section, you can change the panel layouts and it comes with.
Yeah, I mean, that's part of what makes Mate sexifiable. It's a word I'm gonna invent, sexifiable. Because of that Mate tweak thing.
Yeah.
And it's easy to set up.
Yep. Alright, what do you have next?
That's pretty much it. I only have, like, descriptions why I think it's a working man's distro.
Okay. Right, so my last one is sustainability, and this is...
Yeah.
And I wanted to talk about this because, this is, I think the Ubuntu Mate edition is the latest official flavor of Ubuntu.
Yes. Just huge congratulations, I guess.
Yeah, but then, so that makes it
sustainable.
Right. Yeah.
Kind of curious. I should have tried 1404 as well.
I hear 1404 is like the one that they like to push.
Yeah, and you know me, I always like going for LTSs.
Mm-hmm.
So, should have gotten 1404. Either way.
Either way.
Yeah.
What else do we have? GNOME 2. Yeah. Happy birthday, GNOME. Am I excited for stuff coming up?
Oh, yeah. Wait. Are we done talking about Ubuntu Mate?
I think so. This is third worldable.
I mean, just let me clear off the ones on my notes. Okay, so why I think it's a working man's distro? One, I already said that it's plain, but not bland. Easy to set up and customize. And thing is, it has everything you need right off the box. But if you need something else, like GIMP, because GIMP's not in it. But, you know, it's easy to get. I mean, again, it's one of those things that, I'm so used to using Linux right now that when I need something... I don't need to worry about it. I'm just gonna look it up on Google, double check, like, does this exist for Linux? Yeah, it does. So, and then, okay, I could have it depending on how fast my internet speed for the hour is. So, my final conclusion for this is that,
final
is
conclusion.
It third worldable? Oh, yeah. My, last redundancy.
Sorry. Anyway.
My final thought, I guess, is that this could have been great for my desktop. Before it died. This could have been great for my desktop. My very old, like, 6-7-year-old desktop, if it's still alive right now. Oh, man. And I can see this great for schools and workplaces and utility stuff. Cause it's such a, and this is a term that we both like, that we haven't used in a long time. It's so robust.
Yeah, it is. It's robust, exactly.
It's robust. It's such a, it's, I can do this.
It's like the manliest Ubuntu derivative out there.
Yeah. And come on, it's a mate. No, it's a mattress.
It's a mate.
Yar. Yeah, we didn't talk about that. Like, before we were confused how to I was confused because you think
it's on their
Mate.
Website. Like, it says Mate, dude. It's on their website.
No, before, like, it way back.
Yeah, I checked their website. I was like, it's Mate. But then I had to keep the shtick going though. It's like, is it mate or Mate? Is it Mate or mate?
And there we have it. At least we finally got it that it's actually mate.
Is it?
Yeah. But you know what? Really? Oh my god, really? We're going there, huh? We're going there. But yeah. Is it third worldable? Simple answer.
Yes.
Yeah, it is. I have a desktop, I'd put it in right now. Heck, it's in my netbook, so I have it right now.
You know what makes it good, though? I think what makes it third worldable is the fact that it's really old school.
Yeah.
Like,
I agree.
Like, when we were talking about this yesterday, it was like, that was the thing that, struck me about, Ubuntu Mate. It's just really old school. But then it isn't old. Right? It isn't like,
Don't tell me it's a 90s hipster, man. Like, it's a hipster. Looks old, but, you know, very agile.
it's like that ska band, the Pie Tasters. The Pie Tasters. Yeah. Or,
those are still at it. But they're not old. Like, and it doesn't even look old.
Yeah, but then it's old school. It's,
The spirit is there.
Yes. Yes, that's pretty much it. It's a good melodic hardcore band that takes its roots from stuff like Bad Religion or yeah. I'm actually thinking about making a reference to the off tangent that we recorded yesterday, and the audience is going to hear after the little techno music thing that we have in between the main show and the off tangent. It's like that band that we talk about in the off tangent.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot the name of the band last night, and I'm forgetting it now.
NoFX?
No.
Anyone?
The guys that sang Shut Up and Dance.
Shut Up and Dance. The power of the internet is right in our fingertips. Shut Up and Dance. If only it is fast, is how we type. Walk the Moon.
Yeah, Walk the Moon. Yeah, because that song is a really 70s, 80s sort of vibe to it.
Yeah, but they're a new band. They're
the new band, and it's still very, and they're still very modern sounding. But then they do take a lot of their cues from, bands like the Talking Heads. But then, like, it has that very 21st century slick overproduction. You know? So, you know, they sort of take something old, but then incorporate a lot of the new and shiny on it. So they have very old school kind of sound, and that's what I feel Ubuntu Mate is.
I agree. Yep, pretty much. What else?
What else do we have to say?
Do we have other things we need to say? I'm okay now. I'm done.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, one more thing. Startup time is a bit slow, but it's not like... It's not a, you know... It doesn't kill you.
Actually, I also noticed that, though. But then...
It's not gonna kill you. I mean, you're used to, what, a 7-second startup time because of Arch. So, you're... like,
no, seriously. It's not that fast. Sorry. 47. Well, just to peek behind the curtain, dear listeners, I coughed. And
the power of editing was just experienced by everyone.
I'm still coughing. It's the weather.